We begin with the top stories tonight, where more than 60 people have died from flood-related incidents as the ongoing heavy rains continue to wreak havoc across the country. In Nairobi's Mathare area, where floods left a trail of destruction on Tuesday night, the death toll has climbed to 14 following the recovery of four more bodies on Thursday. Four of the victims are members of one family, with two more still missing at the close of the search and rescue operation this evening. Ben Kirui has more.
The search and rescue efforts in Nairobi's Mathare area continued into the second day on Thursday as the community rallied together in the face of Mother Nature's fury. Despite the grim task, their relentless determination led to the recovery of three more bodies, bringing the toll to 14 since Wednesday. Collins Oyengo's family suffered the most loss after the floods swept away their home on Tuesday night, with the four family members recovered and the fate of two others uncertain. Their anguish is palpable.
Mimi nimepoteza familia yangu wote, wenye walikuwa kwa hiyo nyumba. Juu maji ilikuja kazidi nyumba, nyumba ikabomoka, ikawafinya ndani. Na kwa hiyo nyumba yetu tulikuwa hata na jirani mwenye alikuja kutafuta usaidizi kwa hiyo nyumba. Yeye alikuwa na watoto tatu. Na mimi mamangu anaishingi na yeye na watoto watatu.
In the tragic incident, six members of one family and a neighbor found themselves caught in the merciless flood waters of the Nairobi River.
Hiyo jana tulijaribu kutafuta, tafuta, tukapata watu tatu. Leo asubuhi tukatafuta, tukapata moja. Sasa hiyo inaleta the number kuwa four. So bado tunatafuta watatu. Mimi kwa familia yangu natafuta watu wawili. Na kwa hiyo familia ya jirani tunatafuta mmoja.
Just like Collins, many families are in pain and grief. Chantel Nyangi has been searching for her missing 10-year-old son since Tuesday night.
No, but mnisaidie tu mtoto wangu tu apatikane tu. Sijui kako waya mama shakufa. Ni Simone nimetembea du hiro yote paka uko river side sijampata. Sijamuona.
Chantel, a distraught situation, underscoring the anguish felt by many families in Mathare who continue to cling to hope amidst the devastation. Beyond the loss of lives, the community grapples with the harsh reality of their future, enduring nights in the cold without government aid.
Tumeita marafiki kuje tusaidiane kwa sababu hatujaona mkono wa serikali kwa hili janga. Wanakuja wanapiga picha huko juu na wanaenda, so sisi ndio waadhiriwa, lazima tushughulike.
I need help, I need machinery on the ground, I need those people wasimame hapa wasaidie watu hapa, kuna mili mingi sana, more bodies are here, even NYS wako hapa watoke na machinery zao, cause kama mimi na retrieve mili na mkono hivi bila gloves eh, na watu wenye wanafaa kusaidia wako.
Despite the efforts of the local rescue teams, an unknown number of individuals remain unaccounted for, with the rescue team majorly comprising of the locals combing through the river downstream without proper equipment.
As the water recedes, it presents the community of Mathare with a chance to turn every block and every stone, hoping to retrieve bodies of the missing individuals. Ben Kirui, Citizen TV, Nairobi.